Hello everyone, Samantha here. I pray all is well with everyone. In this video, I'm going to be doing a Bible journaling page for my Bible journal challenge for the book of Titus. This week is chapter 3. And I've already read Titus 3. And I'm going to go to that chapter and share the verse that is on my heart to journal on. But let me just say something before I go into that. On this page here, I did this page back in 2015, January 18, 2015. And as you see, some of the words are, covered. Since this is an art journal and Bible, and it's for that purpose, when I first started in this journal, which was in this Bible journal, back in 2015, I attempted to, I did this page, and I didn't like it afterwards. It's not that I don't like the design, but what I don't like is that I covered my words. And I'm not saying that it's wrong, but it bothered me afterwards. Someone had said something to me. I was in this group and someone, this man, he was in this group and he attacked me for it. But that's not why I felt bad about it. I don't know why that man did that. I mean, I don't know. I don't know if he was a troll or whatever, but at any rate, I didn't like it anyway. I don't like covering up the words. Even though right here, the words are showing for the verse that I'm journaling on, I prefer that all my words on my page, show. So with something like this, and I tried to do a curtain on the kitchen, as you can see. I mean, I did the best that I could do, at the time. It's more like a large doodle of a curtain, a kitchen curtain, and I have a godly home, whatever. But I would have preferred to do something like this with a translucent color, like a translucent purple, gray, and even brown down here for the ledge. And right here, where I could still see my words. But, I think I've mentioned that before, that I don't like doing that. So, as you can see right here, some of this paint, because this is so old, it rubbed off onto this page. But I'm still going to use this page, and because the verse that I want to journal on is on this page. And it's Titus 3:8. And I want to read it. In this version, which is, I believe, the NIV, and make sure, I don't think I ever told the version of this Bible, it's crossway, oh no, I'm sorry, ESV, English Standard Version. So I'm going to read it here, and I'm going to also read it in the King James. So, hold on 1 minute. So in the English Standard Version, it reads, "The saying is trustworthy, and I want you to insist on these things, so that those who have believed in God may be careful to devote themselves to good works." And in the King James Version, it reads, Titus, I hope I didn't say first Titus. Titus 3, hold on 1 second, Titus chapter 3, verse 8. Okay. So, it says, in the King James Version, it reads, "This is a faithful saying, and these things I will that thou affirm constantly, that they which have believed in God might be careful to maintain good works. These things are good and profitable unto men." And oh yeah, and let me read it in the English Standard Version because I left off on part of the verse. I'm sorry. The saying is trustworthy, and I want you to insist on these things so that those who have believed in God may be careful to devote themselves to good works. These things are excellent and profitable for people. That's awesome. And what the Lord had just placed on my heart was that, you know, as believers, we are to do good works. We're actually created for good works. We are His workmanship created unto good works. And I'm going to put that scripture up there when I upload the video. Matter of fact, let me go there because there's no harm in going there. Workmanship. You know, His workmanship created for good works. That's why. Right here. For we are His workmanship created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Right? So, we are God's people, God's chosen, God's called, created in Christ Jesus, right? Unto good works. God created us to do good works, right? And over here in Titus 3:8, you know, Paul is admonishing Titus to teach, yes, those that believe in God, they need to devote themselves to good works, maintain good works. The Lord took it a step further with me the other day, and He was like, yes, because that's what glorifies me. The scripture is let your light shine. So this is Matthew 5:16. It says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So the Lord just spoke to my heart. He said, you know, when you maintain good works, when you devote yourself to good works, when my children do this, it's letting their light shine. And that brings glory to me. Glory to God. Not saying me, Samantha. You know what I mean. Glory to God. And if you read the scriptures before that, it says, you know, no one lights a candle and put it underneath a bushel. But they put it, you know, up. They, you know what, matter of fact, let me not mess that up. Let me just go there. Because sometimes when I start paraphrasing, I get things all mixed up. Sometimes I know the full scripture. Sometimes I don't. So let me just go there. I don't want to go to Matthew 5. Matthew chapter 5. Right? So that's where I'm now. Matthew 5. Okay, let's see. Okay, it says, ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Right. So, the Lord was telling me it's false humility to try to like hide yourself. Like when God is trying to push us to the forefront, and maybe we don't want to be in the forefront, and maybe we're not desirous of praise, and we don't desire the accolades of other people. We could care less whether they praise us or not. And I think that's a good place to be, because then our significance is in God, and it's not like we need the praise of man. And I find that that's really a place of peace. You know, just to do what we do is unto the Lord, and whether anyone acknowledges it or whether few people acknowledge it, it's what God sees, and He's grateful, and He's, well, I shouldn't say grateful. Well, God, I believe that is a characteristic of God, grateful, but He's pleased, and, you know, and He rewards us openly. So whatever we do in secret, so we don't need the accolades from each other, even though it can come in a form of encouragement, and I think it's healthy, but I think it's unhealthy when that's what causes us to thrive, and we can't thrive without that. Especially as adults in the Lord, as children, you know, children need that that constant encouragement, and we all need encouragement. But I think you know what I mean when I say, like, there's a healthy sense of getting compliments from people, and it helps us, and God uses that, versus our significance being in that, and we can't go any further unless everybody or a lot of people are patting us on the back. I used to be in that place too, and I know that that's a very unhealthy place, and it's a place of hindrance, and that's another lesson, so I'm not going to go into that. But going back to what I said about forced humility, trying to hide ourselves, the Lord, you know, had to deal with that. So what I was saying was, you know, the Lord just speaking to my heart about me just trying to go in hiding and, like, oh, I don't want to be in the forefront with anything. I'm just okay with being behind the scenes. And the Lord explained to me, like, when he is trying to put us in the forefront and he's giving us a platform, and he's telling us to do something, and it might be something he wants us to do publicly, to try to, like, not do it, or just try to hide for the sake of fear or timidity or whatever. Whatever the reason may be, God understands. But it is not humble. It is not humble when it's like, no, God, I don't want anyone to see. Or I'm okay back here, and God is saying, no, I want you to go forward in this. That's not humble. And it's like trying to hide the light. And our light, we know, is Jesus Christ. And our good works, you know, that God have us to do, and by his spirit, and he's telling us to do, those are the works that are wrought in God. And so, yeah, maintain the good works. Like he said, this is profitable unto men, or men. And it is. It gives God's glory. It gives God glory, but it benefits. I mean, I think about the different things that God had me do, and it doesn't only benefit my life, it benefit the lives of others. So yes, so the English Standard Version, it says devote themselves to good works, and in the King James Version, it says maintain good works. So that's encouraging. God says, keep on doing the good that I have you to do. It brings me glory. It blesses not only your life, but the life of others. And you are a light. And you have the light. I am the light. You are the light of the world. That's what God says in his word, Matthew 5. And it says, let your light so shine. Because we are one in Christ. Those that are in the Lord is one spirit. We are one in God. And as Jesus is in this world, so are we. He is light, we are light. And he says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works. God wants them to see. And this is not braggadocious. This is not bragging. God says, do it. It's out in the public. You know you're not doing it for accolades. You know you're not doing it for praise. God says share something. God says give something. Now, there are times when God tells us to do things in secret. But there are times he's going to put us on a platform and people are going to see. And those that have a heart for God, they're going to glorify God. And there's some people that don't even know the Lord, but they're going to say, surely God is in this place. Surely God is with him. Surely God is with her. You see, it's going to give God glory. It's like, I wonder how they did that. Or I wonder why they're like that. And it starts pointing them to Jesus. And points them to Jesus. So yes. And we should encourage each other. As Titus, God, as Paul is encouraging Titus. You know, he said this is a trustworthy saying. This is a faithful saying. And I want you to insist on these things. So it's this insistence. Like, yes. Maintain those good works. So I pray that encourages someone. That encourages me big time. Because I used to feel like, oh, that's bragging and boasting or whatever. Please. No. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I remember there was sometimes that I thought like that when I would see some people. Lord, you tell me, you just jealous. Sometimes that's what it was. Oh, look at them. They think they all are that. No, that person is not doing that. That person is genuinely just sharing what God placed on their heart, sharing what the goodness of the Lord. Get your mouth and your mind off of them and just do good works too, as unto the Lord. So, you know, and if we do note that someone is boasting or bragging for whatever reason, we pray for them, but we're all susceptible, and I'm sure we all have done it at some point. But we're not to let that stop us. Maintain those good works. And I don't know about you, but I do not want to operate in false humility because of fear, because of what other people may think, or because of my own flesh. Like, oh, I don't feel like being bothered with the attention. You know, it may sound good. I don't want the attention. It may sound good, but if it's not about us and it's about Jesus and letting his light shine, then he's going to put us on display at times. He's going to bring attention to us because he knows he's placed it in our heart to point people to Jesus. So, with that being said, oh, let me just say this last thing. And I remember that I was talking to a sister in church, and we was talking about like not wanting the attention, and so sometimes we minimize our giftings or whatever. We was talking about it, and you know, like just confessing this sin that we were participating in, you know, for whatever reason. I'm not gonna go on into that, but I was like, you know, I said, think about the burning bush and Moses, how God got Moses' attention. God, that bush caught Moses' attention because God put that bush on fire. And I said, sometimes, I said, no, I didn't say sometimes. I said, that reminds me of us. God puts us on fire, Holy Ghost and fire, the anointing, right? The anointing, right? That powerful, powerful anointing of God is on us. And we are ablaze in God. And then people look. They look at us. They watch us. And it's like, let me turn aside and see who this is. You know how Moses says, let me turn aside and see this bush and why it's burning. And then as he start coming closer, God told him to take off his shoes because he was on holy ground. And then God can do that with people. It's not that they're going to take off their shoes, but God can let them know there's something different about them. And then they know, they've heard, oh, you're a Christian. You know, this person is in God. And then they even could discern the holiness. They may not know what it is, but it doesn't mean that they don't discern it. And they may not know what to call it, but they know it's something different. So, again, maintain those good works in the name of Jesus as unto the Lord. And we're going to keep glorifying our Father, which are in heaven, and God help us to continue to let our light shine and let it, us not quench it for no one, no evil thought from the enemy, no one's words, whatever. Let us shine, Jesus. Shine. You shine through us, Lord. And we pray not to hide the light. We pray not to hide you. We pray not to quench the spirit, but to go forth in you and do all that you've called us to do for your name's sake, for our benefit, the benefit of others, and to glorify you. And we thank you and we praise you, Father God, in Jesus' name. So, with that being said, I've already started the video. So, and I'm showing the products as I was going along. So, I'll be back at the end of the video to share a review of what I did. All right. God bless you.
Blessing to see people with their heads up to the sky still. 'Cause honestly, for the same people, life can be so real. you why. I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful,
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 beautiful.
Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful.
Many mighty ships are sinking. Many stars are falling down. And I count it as a blessing that you hold me up now. I can tell that you've been praying. My whole life has turned around. Yeah, yeah. And I can't go without saying that I thank God for you all now. Yeah, for you I
put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful. Now put your lighter in the air for us. Everybody singing together, sing a new song. Put your lighter in the air for love. It's beautiful,
beautiful,
beautiful.
Let me say yeah, 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 yeah. Say yeah, 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 yeah. Let me hear you say yeah, 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 yeah.
See what you go through.
Alright.
Put my lighter in the air.
The truth is, you're beautiful. Whoa.
Beautiful.
Whoa.
Now put your lighter in the air.
Put
for
your
us.
Lighter in the air.
Everybody
for
singing
us.
Together, sing a new song.
Alright.
Put your lighter in the air for love.
Oh, you're
it's beautiful.
Whoa.
Beautiful.
Let me say yeah, 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 yeah.
Hello everyone. So I'm back and I'm done. Right here, you can see I wrote maintain. Then I put some stickers for good works. This part of the tissue, I don't think I put a lot of matte medium on it or enough. And so when I went to use a Sharpie on it, it started bleeding out. But I kind of fixed it with this Pentel pen that I just got from Latricia. So, I noticed that I couldn't use, like, that kind of liquid Sharpie ink. But this pen, like a ballpoint pen, it helped to stop it from bleeding and showing it spread out so much. But then I had to go back and thicken the letters, and I didn't really think about... Oh, God. Something fell behind the desk. I'm going to have to get it later. Okay, I'm sorry about that. But I wasn't thinking about thinking in the letters like that, but it just so happens that I had to because the Sharpie marker, excuse me, this one right here, it started bleeding. Anyway, so, and then I used the stickers, the letter stickers, to spell out good works. Then I put this sticker here, praise the Lord. And as you can, if you watched the video, you saw that I used this pearl paint and I watered it down a bit so it won't be so thick to make it a bit more translucent, because this is translucent, but I was concerned that the words would be blocked out a bit, so I just wanted to water it down a bit. But then I noticed that it was too light, so what I did was I put some of the paint straight from the container on the page, but when I was painting on the words, I made sure I used the paint that I put water on, that I watered down a bit. Then I stenciled on some yellow paint, some yellow craft paint, using a decorative stencil, which you saw in the video. And you can see it, actually see it through the page if you look carefully. I mean, you don't have to even strain to look. I mean, I'm looking right at it and I can see the pop of yellow in the background. So, I really like that because it contrasts with this orange and yellow flower that was on the tissue paper. So, what else did I do? Oh, yeah. And then I used these glitters that I got from the Dollar Tree. Not did I get the, yeah, I got that from the Dollar Tree. It's the Jot brand. Yeah. No, it's not Jot. It's called Crafter Square. It's a dollar. Look at those pretty colors. I got that a while ago. So I just put some matte medium around it. And my first thought was to like just do it in between and everything. And even right here, that could have took some right there and some right there. I might just do that right now. Hold on 1 second. I can do that on camera. Hold on. Okay, I found the gloves. So this right here. Yeah, so I think I'm going to just make a little bit because I didn't want to put it all over and then I couldn't write. That was my concern. When I started putting it here, that was my intent to put it all over. But then I was like, wait a minute. Suppose the pen can't write on it. So, oops, that's a bit too much. But that's what I just... That's why I like shakers. You know, they do have shakers. Do I have any shakers? You know what? I think I have like 2 or 3. So maybe I'll transfer some of this. It's great. Just pouring from the bag, you know, it's hard to like control it a bit. It may just pour out more than you want it to. So hold on 1 second. Here's my okay. So yeah. So I'll do that. Make some. So I'll just go in here now. Now that you know I did the writing and stuff like that. So I didn't want to write too much on here like I normally do. I just want to put maintain good works. I'm going to go back in and highlight that scripture too. So this is very relaxing. Very, very relaxing. I like this. On the train. So right here. I gotta be careful with that Sharpie because that will smear. And I'm not gonna like that black looking stuff. And I don't want the glitter to be clumped up. It looks clumped up right here a bit. I don't like that, but yeah. It was something that I already mentioned that. So yeah, and I put a little bit of sprinkles on the letters here. And now we'll go up here and here a bit. Maybe right here. I'm not gonna mess nowhere near these words. I could still read that entire page, all that text if I wanted to. You see what I was saying about putting down, I put down too much of that glitter paint, that glitter. You can see it right there, it's just too much. Maybe I could do something here. But I'm not gonna do the entire birdcage. Just in between. I think it looks nice when it contrasts a bit. Contrast. Yeah, like that. And then come in here. Well, maybe I didn't put too much. I could always thicken the border too. I think that's what I'll do with the rest of this. Yeah, so that was my original intent. And like I said, I got concerned that I wouldn't be able to write, so I stopped. And then I was putting it up there, and I was like, you know what? Why not just make that the border? I was thinking about using this as the border at first, the pearls. I would like to put another pearl right here. So, You know, sometimes when you finish with the page and you go back, you may see a couple of things that you would like to fix. So, I'll put that right there. It's like I put it on a little swirlies. Oops, that came right up. I need some glue for that. So, I'll go ahead and put right there. And then I'll put this down. This has already an adhesive on it. But you know, sometimes once you pull it up off the plastic, and then I had to pull off the long piece of plastic that was on it. Kind of. And then there's another curly thing right there. So I think I'll go ahead and put one there. So it's like me right now just putting the finishing touches while I'm explaining. I'm seeing where something could go. Put a little bit here. And I think I am going to use that to thicken up the border instead of wiping it up. See? And if that moves, I can always use this right here because it has a pointy tip just like the other one that I just got from Latricia. Okay, I'm going to go over here. But it's for writing. That other one is for writing. This one right here is not for writing. So when I want to go and write, I could use that glue. And I did a technique before in my rectus journal where I have another video like that, I think, where I used the glue when I was doing mixed media morsels. I used the glue to as a resist. And that was fun. Yeah, I enjoyed that group when I was in it on Facebook a while ago. You know, but I haven't really been interacting much in other groups besides my group. Like, I'll check in and the groups that I'm in, like Jesus Journal Junkies and Let's Get Organized and Expressions of Faith. I really like those groups and I stay in there. I could post in there. Like, I'm going to post in there tonight. Expressions of Faith. And Let's Get Organized. But when I started my group, you know, things kind of like, you know, kind of slowed down with me posting in other groups. Because, you know, when you're an administrator of another group, it takes work to maintain it and stuff like that. And then stuff like that. So, and I take my group seriously, like, you know, what I do there, seriously. And God knows. So, you know, it takes effort and time. So, yeah, so right now what I'm doing is just putting down, put a little bit more matte media. Just thicker, putting it down to thicken the border. I didn't go over that flower right there. I left that flower alone. This part right here is nice. So yeah, well, that's just thickening it up. And I'm gonna go and underline the scripture in a minute. Yes, so I'm trying to use all of this, as you can see. I don't want it to be patchy. Like thick patches. So that's real glittery. That's okay, so let me hold on 1 second. Let me clean off this brush and then clean it before this thing hardens on here. Hold on. Okay, yeah. And I just thought about it. I just want to make sure that, you know, I explain it. I put down a napkin. This is the napkin I got from Shea Rotino. I think I'm going to leave the link down in the description section if I can find it once again. Oh, yeah, you know what I think I could do? I think I could go to the video where I did the haul for these napkins and retrieve it from there instead of going on Facebook and browsing for it. So I'm going to underline this. The saying is trustworthy, and I want you to insist on these things so that those who have believed in God may be careful to devote themselves to good works. these things are excellent and profitable for people. Right there. So I did a light underline. Right? And like I said, I could still read the text, so I'm grateful for that. I still got a dry bit. And you know what? I'm thinking I should stamp this. Should I? No, I'm not going to stamp this page. I'm going to stamp another one that I do. It's another one that I'm doing, hopefully tomorrow. Yeah, hopefully tomorrow I'll do the other page. Yeah, so that's Titus 3:8, and that's my page. And I want to say thanks for watching. God bless you. And I encourage you to maintain and devote yourself to good works. May God help us all to let our light shine for him and not hide his light, but and not be timid. Maybe you're watching this and you're not timid. Maybe you just like, hello everyone, here I am, and Jesus is with me, and Jesus said, and let Jesus shine. But then there may be some of us that may be feeling a little reluctant or shy or whatever. And I can feel that way too at times. You know, the enemy says something that makes me want to, like, you know, pull back. But I see God really helping me with that. And so I pray for all of us in the body of Christ that we just go forth and do what God will have us to do and let his light shine, and he will get the glory. I had to come back because I forgot that I wanted to put a tab on here on this page. And I'm going to put this word right here, good, right here. This is from the Tim Holtz. What is this one called? Big Chat. Right here. This right here. So I'm putting the sticker good on there. Right. And then I'm going to put it on the page. So I'm trying to see where I'm going to put this. Right. Maybe right here. Right here. Yeah, right there. Is that thing crooked? Yeah, it is. Alright. Oh, be careful. Okay. I always have a difficulty putting these things on here. I don't know why. I don't know what that's about. Okay. So I'm not gonna burnish it down into, see? I gotta move down some. Oh, okay. I think it's important to get that the back lined up first. And then I think that's decent. Okay. It could be also too the way that it's on the page. So I don't want to be too much of a stickler there. Because the napkin itself could be on a small slant. And I just didn't see it. So I have that for good. And then I remember I got these from Latricia. And I was moving my stuff around and I saw it. And I said, oh, it's glittery. It'll look nice on this page. It's not a sticky back. It's an embellishment that it doesn't have adhesive. So I put a little bit of that on there. And then I'll put this here. Yeah, I like that. Praise the Lord. Right under there. Okay. Okay, so I want to say, yeah, I like that there. Okay. 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 So I want to say thanks for watching. God bless you. And remember, Jesus loves you. Bye-bye.